What's up, guys? Tonight, actually, very soon, I'm gonna be back over at the district with my good buddy DJ Core. The last time I was at the district was New Year's Eve with DJ Core. If you guys missed that video, it'll be linked up in the little pop-up box that's popping up right now. Anyway, I gotta go pretty soon. Man, it just gets dark like really fast. Like 7:30 right now. Doors open at 8. And like you guys might have seen in the other video of when I was at the district, it's like a parking lot like away from this hotel, which is really nice. And he's got like a really cool production setup. I'm not gonna give it away. I'll just show you guys when we get there. Here's some of the gear I'm gonna be using tonight. I'm gonna be using my stabilizer for some of the shots. Got my Switch here. Had a little time to play some Mario Odyssey today. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this room for now. So I'm gonna head on over to the district and take you guys along. Just got to the district now. They're just finalizing some stuff in the stage production right there. Doors already open, so I'm gonna assume music's gonna start really soon. Then you guys won't be able to hear me at all.
Cool.
But I am backstage right now, and I didn't really show you guys like the backstage before. Last time for New Year's, there was a table here. I don't know where that is, but yeah, it's pretty much the green room here. I don't think this monster fridge was here last time. But it's here now, and I just kind of want to show you guys what's all going on in this fridge.
Okay,
so we got some of Coors beer, Boulevard, unfiltered wheat. We got some 16-ounce Coors Lights, some other Coors Lights that I think are gone, some Mountain Dew, some Waterway down there, some Hy-Vee grape something, grapefruit. And the thing I wanted to show you guys is this fucking grapefruit, or not grapefruit, this avocado. Like, one, like, I don't know what you mix an avocado with, alcohol-wise. And two, how long has this been in here? Alright, so, I got my setup. I'm not sure, like, if I'm gonna use my stabilizer very much, because the live shots just seem to be doing better right now. I'll do a what's in my bag eventually. For some of you that are interested in that kind of thing, I think a lot of you are more interested in my Blackmagic pocket cinema camera setup, and I'll show you guys that sometime too. So I'm gonna get back to the party. I'll bring you guys along. Crazy production going on tonight. And yeah, another cool thing is, like, I didn't really have a costume or whatever, and this is like my weakest attempt at a costume is Rick from Rick and Morty. And like all the other Ricks in the crowd are like, we're like pointing at each other, you know, because like we know. It's like, hey man, cool. All right, let's get back to the party.
Ten years ago, on the night of October 31st, a small town fell victim to an escaped killer. Under the cover of darkness, he carried out the most horrifying mass murder on record. Ever since that night, no one has forgotten his name.
Surprise, we're gonna have some fun!
And Halloween has never been the same.
Alright, we just had that really cool intro by DJ Core. That was really awesome. The hard part about that, well, maybe for me anyways, is that when when the lights are projecting out towards the crowd, like, obviously it was just, like, blown out, right? And I didn't actually know that was gonna happen. I thought it would have been more on him. But anyway, so it got, like, super blown out, and, like, when I'm filming at night, I kind of have to, like, try to figure out the medium, because those lights jump around so much, it could be, like, bright, and then dark, and then bright, and then, like, medium or whatever. So, like, when that shot out there like that, it just blew it all out. I was like, shit.
If love is a lie, then why do we need it? We swear we're alive, but we're falling to pieces. We fight like lions, we howl at the moon. We should be flying, instead we bury the truth. But I know it's all.
Alright guys, that's gonna do it for the video. Last night was a lot of fun. Ran into a lot of old friends that I haven't seen for a while, and I didn't know that I was gonna be there. My buddy Blake Spinks, DJ Spinix, like, I had no idea he was gonna be there. I was actually outside of the hotel and he was driving by and he was like, "Hey buddy," and I was like, "Holy shit, are you gonna be at the district?" And he's like, "Yeah." And then I saw my buddy Zach, he was there, Zio. Didn't expect to see him, and I didn't expect to meet Tosh from Andy and Tasha in the morning on 104.7. That was, like, really cool. I hear her voice like every day, you know, and I finally got to meet her. She was one of the Sanderson sisters, which is really cool. And I don't think I ever mentioned in this video that this is for the Halloween weekend at the district, but whatever. Anyways, I'm gonna get back to Iowa. I woke up super early. I was gonna fly my drone, but it's like, you can tell that it rained and stuff. It's not raining right now, but I'm still not gonna fly. I'm just gonna head back to Iowa. Anyways, Mario Odyssey, super fun game if you guys, you know, get a chance to play it. But that's gonna do it for me. Hope you guys had fun watching. Thanks once again for hanging out, and huge thanks to DJ Core for always inviting me to all the fun stuff that you do. All of his social sites will be in the description box below, where you can find his music, his upcoming events. The guy's got a lot of really cool stuff going on all the time. I will come try to hang out as much as possible with you. Of course, we'll keep in touch, and I will speak to all of you later. Like, all of you guys that are listening that I'm talking to right now. Okay, bye.